Welcome to the Screening Room, the Movies at Home edition. I'm Russ Simmons.
And I'm Sean Edwards. Here's what's new for your home entertainment viewing pleasure.
Yes, Tina Fey's hit 2004 comedy Mean Girls was adapted into a popular Broadway musical, and now the cinematic version is available on DVD. So the question is, why own the disc when you just stream it? Well, the mini 4K Blu-ray extras include a gag reel, a sing-along edition, and a music video featuring Renee Rapp and Megan Thee Stallion.
Yeah, I like the sing-along part because the songs and the dance numbers are great. But in context of the movie, they all felt forced. Now, the jokes are all recycled and the characters never really get a chance to be the characters. It's modestly amusing, Russ, but Mean Girls is a bit more plastic than the original, at least this version.
I'm giving it three popcorn bags.
Three popcorn bags is what you're giving it. I'm going to go two, but something about that sing-along has got me intrigued.
Okay. Well, Dakota Johnson is passable in one of the weaker Marvel entries, Madam Web, now available on DVD. It's the origin story of a superhero with the ability to see short spans into the future. I see the future of this movie. It's going nowhere. Even though the DVD extras include Easter eggs, a gag reel, and deleted scenes, actually, Sean, they didn't delete enough.
Oh, wow, because Madam Web is so lifeless and unoriginal, it almost feels like a spoof. It's laughably bad. The time has come that studio execs stop trying to breathe cinematic life into minor comic book characters because the result is this.
Two popcorn bags.
No popcorn bag. Come on, this film was a mess. Maybe it's going to live later in time, but I think it's going to be one of those guilty pleasure classics, if anything else. But finally, we have Hip Hop in the White House, and director and journalist Jesse Washington takes a fascinating look at the intersection of hip hop and politics through the lens of how the presidents of the United States digested the culture. From the birth of the genre in 1973, when Richard Nixon was president, to Barack Obama's historic win, which was heavily supported by the hip hop community, to the current president, Joe Biden, it's a fascinating look at how the culture of rapping, DJing, breakdancing, and graffiti leveraged its popularity into political currency. Four popcorn bags.
You can see all of our reviews and interviews with Hollywood's biggest stars at fox4kc.com/screeningroom.
Check us out on YouTube or go to the Fox 4 Screening Room Facebook page where we always give away free movie passes.
That's it for this week. Until next time, I'm Russ Simmons.
And I'm Sean Edwards, Fox 4 News, working for you in the Screening Room.